You are with the fifth educational video on the novel Great Expectations. Today, I am going to present you all an analysis of the character Estella. As usual, I am Manusha Tennakon. If you have not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe it for more videos. Content of today's presentation, I am going to analyze the character Estella under the following topics. Who is Estella? Positive characteristics, negative characteristics, purpose of Estella's upbringing. Why do readers feel sorry for Estella? Who is Estella? Just like Pip, Estella is also an orphan. She does not know even who her parents are. Miss Havisham is Estella's adoptive mother. Estella's real parents are criminals. Magwitch, who is the secret benefactor of Pip, is Estella's father, while Molly, the servant woman of Mr. Jaggers, is her mother. Even though Estella represents the upper class, she is actually even lower born than Pip. Purpose of Estella's upbringing. Estella is adopted by Miss Havisham. But she does so not out of a genuine purpose. Miss Havisham uses Estella as a cat's paw to get her purpose achieved. Miss Havisham wants Estella to attract men using her beauty and break their hearts. Miss Havisham developed a deep-rooted hatred towards men after her fiance jilted her on her wedding day. Just like Pip, Estella is also a bundle of contradictions. Estella's character contains both positive and negative characteristics. Let's pay our attention first to positive characteristics. Estella is very attractive. At the very first day when Pip saw Estella at Sadie's house, he was attracted to her because of her beauty. That attraction prevails with Pip throughout the novel without changing. But sometimes some critics interpret Estella's beauty in a negative way. That is, just as how a candle flame destroys a moth, Estella too uses her beauty and attraction to destroy men's hearts. Estella is honest. She is an honest character, not evil. She is what she was trained to be. She cannot love Pip or Miss Havisham because she was not taught love, and she says so quite honestly. Estella is emotional and sensible. Even though Estella appears unemotional, underneath she is not so. Once she responds to Pip and lets him kiss her when Pip displays bravery, beating the pale young gentleman. Estella is ready to change. When Pip meets Estella at Sadie's house in the last chapter of the novel, she says to Pip, "Suffering has been stronger than all other teaching. I have been bent and broken, but I hope into a better shape." This indicates that she is a better person now and she is ready to change further for better. Now, let's pay our attention to the negative characteristics of Estella. Estella is unkind, harsh, cold, heartless, cruel, and also there are many more negative adjectives attached to Estella's character. Estella's unkind and cruel nature can be seen since her childhood. When Estella saw Pip for the first time, she mocks at Pip for his common background. Despite having only just met Pip, Estella thinks nothing of insulting someone who is a guest in her home. She repeatedly calls Pip boy in order to demonstrate her superiority, though she is only a girl herself. She also makes nasty comments about his hands and boots. Estella behaves as if she is heartless. Actually, she is a heartless puppet controlled by Miss Havisham. Once Estella herself said to Pip, I have a heart to be stabbed or shot in. I have no doubt, and of course, if it ceased to beat, I would cease to be. Why do readers feel sorry for Estella? Her behavior is not entirely her fault. She is a victim. She is subject to abuse by her adoptive mother, Miss Havisham, psychologically. She was married to a cruel nobleman. Life in the upper class does not bring salvation to Estella. Instead, she is victimized by her adoptive class. Rather than being raised by Magwitch, a man of great inner nobility, she is raised by Miss Havisham, who destroys her ability to express her emotions and interact normally with the world. Rather than marrying the kind-hearted commoner Pip, Estella marries the cruel nobleman Drumly. He treated her harshly and makes her life miserable for many years. According to these factors, it seems that Dickens uses Estella's life to reinforce the idea that one's happiness and well-being are not deeply connected to one's social position. We have come to the end of today's presentation. Hope to meet you once again with an educational video like this. Thank you.